Hello and welcome. I'm Lena, and I decided to come on today to talk about vulnerability and your comfort zone. And I'm just going to talk, and if you join me and you happen to see this and you like it, that's great. But to keep myself in the flow, I am going to respond to any comments that you might share while I'm chatting here after the video. So feel free to comment, but I wanted to come on and talk about this vulnerability in your comfort zone because, to be honest, I don't like to be vulnerable. In fact, I think it was Sunday, I posted on Instagram a post about vulnerability, and my first sentence was, "It's not easy for me to be vulnerable online." And then I was like, that's not true. That's just where you are right now. It's actually not easy for you to be vulnerable no matter where you are. And I don't believe I'm alone in this. So if you're watching this and you can relate, you're watching it later, like give me a like or a love or write the word comment, write the word vulnerability in the comment box so that I'm not standing out here on the vulnerability cliff by myself. But here's the truth. I believe that me staying here today, talking about vulnerability, telling you that I do not feel super comfortable being vulnerable, is my hope, my intention is that you will benefit from me sharing myself vulnerably. For a long, long time, I felt like I couldn't be all of who I was because I didn't think I'd be accepted or appreciated or liked. And that was part of how I grew up, because I grew up a chubby kid and I was made fun of and all that stuff. So that ingrained in me, but it carried out into my work life. And it carried into, like, even when I worked with certain coaches, I saw them portray this part of themselves that appeared to be like they had everything together. But I know and I knew that they were working on things on the inside, and as am I, as we all are, whether it's intentionally and with awareness or unconsciously and through the experiences that the universe is giving us. So I've chosen to share with you my processes, because I'm not perfect. None of us are perfect. And it is my aim that when you see me share myself imperfectly, that you are then given permission or feel compelled to share yourself imperfectly. So that's the vulnerable part of the story. And that shifts into my comfort zone and the big declaration I made for myself the other day. So I went on a walk. I love walking at Forest Park. I live here in St. Louis. So if you are a local, you know what I'm talking about. I don't always walk with music, but when I do, I get into the groove, and I was feeling really free. I love to be in nature, and it allows me to ground into myself and just feel my body, because we're one with nature. We are made from her. And while I was dancing and singing and walking, I realized that I spend too much time in a box of what I have to do, whether that's producing content for my business, teaching my yoga classes, my own practices and routines and exercises, and not enough time playing, not enough time having fun. And so it's like, screw this. I need to make time for fun. I need to give myself the gift of play so that I can release some of this energy that's stuck in my head. Because as a natural doer, I'm a Virgo rising. I grew up I'm the oldest child of four. I have always provided for myself and always done the job. I'm like a typical kind of type A person in the way that I want to do it right. I want to be acknowledged for it, and I want to receive the results from my actions, right? So if you can relate, let me know. But I'm finding that that's not serving me in the grand scheme of things. While there is a purpose and a place for my actions and my results-oriented mindset and productivity, there is that part of me and that skill set that has been so well developed is bleeding into the other side, the fluid side, the flow side, the play, the freedom, all of which were my main reasons for making a plan to leave my corporate job to create flow, freedom, and play in my life. And it's taken me about 6 months to realize that I haven't done quite a lot of play, fun, freedom, and flow. It ebbs and flows like we all do, but the bigger weight is this right side, this doing, okay? So I was on the walk and I'm like, screw this, I need some play, and I love music and I love to dance, like what can I do? And boom, instantly I hear pole dancing, go take a pole dancing class. It's been in the back of my mind for a long, long time. I don't know how to do it. I've done it once like 17 years ago, so it's not in my body. It's not something I teach. I'm completely unfamiliar, right, for the most part. So I can go into it from a place of total beginner's mind, hence the name of the class, but from a place of receiving and letting myself be in the moment of what I'm doing rather than planning, forecasting, projecting forward and knowing what I'm doing and getting stuck up here in my mind, right? So I declared while I was walking, hi Mira, that I would do this. And this was a few weeks ago, and in the meantime I had had a trip. But I made that intention. I reached out to the Michelle Minks Academy here in St. Louis, got the schedule, and put on my calendar Sunday, just last Sunday, so the 23rd, 1:30 beginner pole dancing class. And I held myself accountable to go to it because I know that it's what I need right now. That class is feeding the fluid flow, beginner mindset, detached sensation, like energy that I need more of to balance out this energy over here that knows what it's doing. So I'm just sharing that with you because we all have a comfort zone. And there's a reason it's called comfort zone, because it's freaking comfortable, right? And you don't want to leave it because there's also a reason why you have it. There's some sort of protection that you get in staying in your comfort zone. And for me, taking myself out of what I know into a new activity, into a new place where I don't know anyone, challenged me in a couple of ways. It challenged me to connect, which I'm also building that skill. It challenged me to connect, like to go in with an open mind, open heart, without judgment. And I'm proud to say, accomplished. I met a new friend. I had a great time. And I wasn't thinking about it. And I'm so happy that the universe provided me with a pole that wasn't directly in front of the mirror so that I wasn't distracted by looking at myself to see if I was doing it right. Because all you doers out there, all of you women who are driven and you know what to do and you get it done, you know what I mean. You know, you are really good at doing. And when it comes to the other side and resting and relaxing, and I'm not even saying legitimately resting and relaxing. I'm talking about resting in the awareness and resting in the trust, resting in fluidity and flow and not controlling. That's hard. I mean, you'd be lying to yourself if you denied that. So we've all seen that box, right? Comfort zone, like comfort zone and you're in it. And then everything you want is outside the box. It's not that simple. I mean, it's a tool. It's a great tool. And if you're in a workshop situation, hi, Anya, you will probably know what I'm talking about. You've probably seen it. And when you're in a workshop and someone's talking to you about how to get out of your comfort zone, it feels possible, right? It feels like you can do it. But what happens when we leave a workshop situation or we come back home to what we know, right? Back in the comfort zone. While we take some of those things with us, most of us humans do not put into action what it takes to get out of your comfort zone because it's freaking scary and it's uncomfortable. And for most of us, it takes support. Like I wrote in my post the other day, like sometimes it takes a small village to encourage me out of my comfort zone. And that's part of what I do in the work that I do with women. I'm a clarity coach and I help driven women get out of the soul sucking grind so that they trust themselves enough to move forward without fearing failure. You know, I have that help. It's part of what got me to the place to make a plan to leave my job. Am I saying that your comfort zone, like you have to leave your job and do something totally different? No. But what is it that is outside of your comfort zone that requires you to take a teeny tiny step, right? Like for me, it was, I'm going to take this dance class. I can commit to doing that once a week. And it gives me freedom and I get to let go. And I don't have to worry about what somebody's thinking of me, if I'm doing it right and anything like that. So I would love to hear from you. If you would tell me in the comment box, thank you, Anya. I appreciate it. Hi, Tracy. Tell me, going back to the beginning, this is where it gets hard for me. Let me just be real with you. I want to ask you so many questions because I love questions. I love getting information. And there's two ways I can go here. One is, hey, tell me what it feels like when you hear the word vulnerability. Because for most of us, we feel a little bit contracted, kind of scared, and uncertain. And the other question is, what's outside your box? What do you want? And yeah, what's outside your box? What do you want? And are you willing to take a teeny step toward it so that it becomes something that you can experience and achieve? That is my day today, people. I thank you for joining me, and I appreciate you sharing this with any human that you feel would benefit, especially hardworking women who are really pushing it and like going through the motions and feeling really like they have to keep going and going and going to get what they want. There's an easier way, and I'm here to support you if that's you, and I would love for you to share it. Share this if it resonates for you to share. Have a beautiful Tuesday, and I plan on seeing you the next time I feel inspired to share with you some vulnerability and action steps out of your comfort zone. So have a great, great day. Bye.